Good morning, students. Today we are going to start lesson number 4 of Social and Political Life. Lesson name is Key Elements of a Democratic Government. So students, in this chapter we will learn about democracy in South Africa, participating, different ways of participating in the democracy of a country, why is there need to resolve conflict, and equality and justice. Democracy in South Africa. South Africa was earlier governed by the apartheid law. Apartheid means separation on the basis of race. It means discrimination was made on the basis of skin color. These people were divided into white, black, Indian and colored races. These people were not allowed to mix with each other or to live near each other or even to use common facilities. There were separate hospitals, trains, buses, bus stops and ambulances for black and white people. Non-white were not allowed to vote also. Hector and his classmates wanted to learn their local language, that is Zulu, but they were forced to learn Afrikaans language that was spoken by whites. So they joined the protest against the learning the Afrikaans language in school, but the South African police beat up the protesters and killed Hector, and he was died on 16 June 1976. After this, the African National Congress started struggle against the apartheid law under the guidance of Nelson Mandela. At last, South Africa became a democratic country in 1994, in which people of all races were considered equal. Participation. Participation is the main key element of a democratic government. As we read in the previous chapter about democracy, in democracy, people play an important role because supreme power lies with the common people, and these people elect their representatives through voting. These representatives take decisions on behalf of the people, but they keep in mind two things, that is voices and interest of the people. Because whatever they are doing for the welfare of the people. All the governments are elected for fixed period, that is for 5 years. Once a government is elected, it can stay in power for only 5 years. But if they want to be continue in power, then they have to be re-elected by the people. Other ways of participating. Besides voting, there are many other ways of participating in the process of government, like people participate by taking an interest in the working of government, but people also criticize the government when it required. It means people express their views against government's wrong decisions by holding dharnas, rallies, strike, signature campaign, etc. Things that are unfair and unjust are brought forward. Newspapers, magazines, TV also play an important role to discuss government issues and responsibility. Members of minority community also participate by organizing themselves into social movements and seek to challenge the government and its functioning. Need to resolve conflict. Conflict means a serious disagreement between two people or two groups. Conflict occur when some social groups do not get along with each other, and sometimes they use violent means to settle their differences, but it leads to violence, death, fear and tension among others living in an area. So it is the government as well as police duty to ensure that no violence take place and conflicts are resolved carefully and peacefully. What are the other reasons for the conflict? First is religious processions or celebration. Religious processions and celebration can sometimes lead to conflicts. For example, the route of a procession takes may lead to a conflict. Sometimes there is a fear that violence may erupt, or some people can throw stones or trying to disrupt the procession. The police is responsible for ensuring that violence doesn't take place. Next is river. Rivers can become a source of conflict between state. For example, Kaveri River dispute between Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. The water stored in the Krishna Raja Sagar Dam in Karnataka is used for irrigating a number of districts. On the other side, the water stored in the Mettur Dam in Tamil Nadu is used for growing crop. But both dams are on the same river, that is Kaveri River. But both states cannot get as much water as they need for people in their state. This leads to conflict. The central government intervened in the matter to keep the situation under control. Equality and justice. Equality and justice both are the main key elements of a democratic government. They are inseparable. It means we can't separate from each other. The practice of untouchability is now banned by law in order to bring equality and justice in the society. And Dr. B.R. Ambedkar also realized that such practices must not continue in the society. Justice can only be achieved when people are treated equally. So both equality and justice go hand in hand. We can't separate from each other. The government also makes special provisions for groups within the society that are unequal. Like the government takes steps to bring girl child on equal level with boy child.